Meanwhile, back at the cozy cabin in the woods, straight arrow Dick Cohen is urging his client Lee to become part of a traditional family. Lee, who used to be gay, but doesn't want to be anymore.
So Lee, tell me, where are you at today regarding your sense of masculinity and your same-sex attractions?
I'm secure in my masculinity now. I no longer have same-sex attraction.
I know you're going to be a terrific father and a great husband.
Thank you.
The answer to every question I ask is going to be Dick. Are you following me?
Dick!
What's the name of the psychotherapist? Say aloud.
Dick!
Who was expelled from the American Counseling Association for violations of its code of ethics?
Dick!
What scientific evidence is there that sexual preference can be changed through counseling?
Dick!
Okay, then.
I made the journey myself from gay to straight. I not only talk the talk, I've walked the walk.
Well, it's a little more of a sachet.
Some people said, you're born this way. Accept it. This is who you are. And I knew that was a bunch of malarkey. I knew it wasn't how I was born. I knew I was destined to have a wife and children.
And Teller and I were destined to be cowboys. We're such fuck-ups.
So when they experience that healthy love from man, healthy man love, then they can, wow, feel I'm a guy, and experience their gender identity, and then naturally, heterosexual desires ensue. It's the law of physics.
Physics? Oh yeah, right, it's Newton's first law of dick motion. A dick in motion stays in motion, a dick at rest, well, you know.
Joining us now is Richard Cohen, author of the book Coming Out Straight, Understanding and Healing Homosexuality. Mr. Cohen is also head of the International Healing Foundation, which purports to be able to turn gay people straight. Mr. Cohen, thank you very much for being with us tonight. I really appreciate your time.
Thank you for having me, Rachel.
First, let me ask you if I have gotten any facts wrong in anything I just said. I know you haven't been happy with our coverage.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. I appreciate this opportunity. You know, Uganda got it wrong, and I'm sorry to say you did too, Rachel. And I'm grateful to be here to set the record straight about the misrepresentation of our work. Since the 1950s, the Uganda government has punished people for engaging in homosexual behavior. So this is not new. We were invited in the spring of this year, as you said. We sent Caleb Brundage, and he shared his wonderful story of change from homosexual to heterosexual. And he told them to have compassion, love, and understanding for all people who experience homosexual feelings. So we do not believe in this legislation. We had no knowledge of it, and we disavow all relationship to it. We are promoting loving people, loving all homosexual people, people who choose to live a homosexual life or decide to live that, and those who decide to come out straight, like myself and Caleb.
Are you troubled at all to see Stephen Lange holding your book up and citing Coming Out Straight as inspiration? He is the main proponent of the Kill the Gays bill. Does that trouble you at all?
Well, if you listen to his words, he only said that I was teaching about some of the causes, what we believe are the causes of homosexuality. We believe that nobody's born this way. You keep saying, we think people choose to be gay. We do not believe that. I believe that psychologically there are many causes to this phenomena, which means change is possible. So we are not a political organization. We're a therapeutic counseling organization who provide help to men and women with unwanted same-sex attraction and their family members. We do not believe in this legislation, Rachel. We believe in tolerance and love for all people.
I understand that you don't think of yourself as a political organization. The reason that you've been a subject of discussion on this show and the reason I wanted to talk to you about tonight is because your teaching and your activism have been used for a political purpose, which is to promote this bill. And Uganda has a history, as you said, going back many decades of criminalizing homosexuality. But you have told them, particularly in your book, Coming Out Straight, which I understood you you donated multiple copies of to this organization that's promoting this bill. You're telling them exactly what they need to hear in order to justify the Kill the Gays bill. I mean, your book portrays gay people as predators who must be stopped to protect the innocent.
No, not at all. And in fact, Caleb told me he, with passion, shared to these people what he experienced as a homosexual man. And as you heard Stephen Lange say, that people are searching for love. How could they punish? It's just incomprehensible. That they would, as you have said over the last few days in this bill, that they would want to incarcerate or to criminally punish these men and women. We are totally against that. We are for your right and anyone's right to live a homosexual life, and we're for the rights of those who seek change and want to come out
straight. Let me try to make it more comprehensible to you. The legislator who sponsored the bill told the Associated Press today that he insists these strict measures, which I know you abhor, but these strict measures they're proposing, including execution, are necessary in their country to stop homosexuals from recruiting school children. Yeah. Let me also just read to you from your book, okay? Page 49. Homosexuals are at least 12 times more likely to molest children than heterosexuals. Homosexual teachers are at least 7 times more likely to molest a pupil. Homosexual teachers are estimated to have committed at least 25% of pupil molestation. 40% of molestation assaults were made by those who engage in homosexuality. This is the claim that you make in your book that exactly feeds these folks who want to execute people for being gay what they need in order to justify that. Right. Do you stand by what you said in your book?
Actually, you know that one particular quote, when I do republish it, reprint it, we will extract that from it, because we don't want such things to be used against homosexual persons.
That quote is cited, you cite somebody named Paul Cameron as the source of that book. Paul Cameron has been kicked out of the American Psychological Association and the Nebraska Psychological Association and the Canadian Psychological Association, and then he tried to make himself a sociologist. Right. He got kicked out of the American Sociological Association. This is, I know that you say you're not going to include it in edition 3. I'm reading from the second edition here.
Right.
But this is made up, fake authoritative stuff that in other countries is being taken as science and used to justify, quite literally, killing gay people. Do you see now why you're being used in a political context here?
I see that they're using it, but you took that one little quote out of a 300-page book, and the thrust and the gist of the text is why people have same-sex attraction and the opportunity for those with unwanted homosexual feelings to come out of homosexuality. There's nothing in there against people who experience same-sex attraction, and again, our teaching in this country, when we went to Uganda and all over the world, because I've helped thousands of people worldwide, Rachel, come out of homosexuality, and again, our message is one of love and compassion and understanding. Our website is changeispossible.com, and people can see our words for ourselves, that we're about loving people.
I'm happy to help. I mean, I realized I was taking the risk of helping promote you in the way that you think about these things by putting you on the air, but I do think that you've actually got blood on your hands here because of the way that you've been used and your organization has been used and your staffer has been used to make this legislation a reality in Uganda, and I do think it's going to become law. So let me just ask you about something that you wanted to be taken in greater context. Your other recent book, Gay Children, Straight Parents, which I actually have to say, I sort of particularly resent this book because I think people might pick it up without realizing that it's a homosexuality can be cured book. So I think you probably hurt a lot of people with this. But
may I stop you for just a moment? Over the last few days, you've been very pejoratively saying we cure the gay away, and it was pray the gay away. We don't believe in any of that. We never use the cure word at all. We don't tell people to pray this away. That would be ridiculous because there's strong psychological underpinning for homosexual desires. So we're not trying to tell anybody what to do, Rachel. Again, we offer effective counseling, very effective, for those with unwanted same-sex attraction, and the Gay Children, Straight Parents book is for family members. And whether the kids change or not, we say in that book, I say that's not the goal of this treatment plan. It's to learn to love your children well.
I will just quote to you from your own most recent newsletter. For the past 40 years, members of the gay rights movement have been indoctrinating members of society, targeting the youth. As a result of their strategic plan, millions of innocent young children have been enrolled into this false teaching and led into a homosexual lifestyle. The idea that you're not promoting the idea that gay people are something to be feared or that there's any threat from gay people.